time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Romero's a guy that knows that he's going to have to carry his load today, as well as some of his teammates out there, because this is a tough spot. He's been there before, but not everybody has been.
I think patience will be the big word for him today. You know, as a talented wide receiver, you're playing on the road. You want the ball in your hand. You want a chance to make a difference in this game. And if they start off a little bit slow, he's got to be patient and let the game come to him and be a tremendous leader and eventually allow this offense to execute to be able to win this game in a tough environment. That makes it first and ten.
From their own 47-yard line, first down. He's tackled at midfield. Bishop gains around 3 yards on the run.
That makes it second and six.
He's on the run.
Makes it out to about the 36.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Trying to set up a screen pass, and it picked off. He's at the 30. The 10. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. Converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off the mistakes.
And down he goes
at about the 43-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 43. Six-yard line.
Man, that is a great call and a big gain, especially on an early down.
And he might want it all here and does. Missed him.
Almost a touchdown there, but that is a stellar play by the corner to get a hand in and knock it away.
From the 46-yard line, it's second down. Gains his way to the 29-yard line.
By this linebacker. He saw the run was coming and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
From the 30-yard line, second down. Tackle around the 17-yard line. goes. And he tackles him hard at the 8-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. The Falcons had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return.
Brought down at the 11.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. Quick throw, and they got him for a loss. That play was designed to pick up a first down, but they didn't do it.
It looks like the receiver just lost track of where he was on the field.
There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
False start offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks up, and it is good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. It's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Got it, complete, he's out of bounds.
Knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. They can get some protection. They might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
So it's second and 14. Ball on the 39. Complete. Brought down. Nothing doing. Chucks it downfield. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception only to be dropped.
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. He gets hit out of bounds at the 24-yard line. Got to give some applause to the defense. They really came out playing strong today.
Well, you know better than me, Brad. This college football game is about emotion. And to be able to play great defense in a college game, you got to come out and play with your hair on fire. We've seen that from both of these defenses so far.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Throws a strike over the middle. He's taken down right around the 30. From their own 30-yard line, second down. Fires out to his receiver, and they make the stop right around the 32-yard line. They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. He makes it to the 32-yard line. A tight, low-scoring game in that first 15 minutes. Let's see if things open up in the second quarter. The Cougars in front, 7-3. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt.
Decent effort. He's not the type of guy to call a fair catch very often. He does have the ability to make guys miss.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. And they get nice yardage on that run. From their own 33-yard line, second down. And he's going to come up with a sack. The ground and steps out right away.
This guy's got the combination of smarts and reliability that makes a receiver really dangerous. No wonder he's looked to on third down.
Bates gains around 6 yards on the run. It's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. It's the tailback. Nice run to the outside. Bates gains about 4 yards on the play.
That'll bring up third and inches.
He's tackled at about the 47-yard line.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now has really showed a lot of poise, been able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
Second and five here. Ball on the 42-yard line. He fires. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
That makes it first and ten.
It's the ninth play of the drive. On the play.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. Bates picks up about 7 yards on the run. It's the 11th play of the drive. And he's sacked.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Kick is up, and he nails the long field goal. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
Is out to the tailback on the screen. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line. That screen pass nets maybe 5 yards.
It's a well-designed play to the halfback, and it worked at least to get them a medium gain on the play.
They go with a run, and he's brought down in the backfield. From their own 29-yard line, it's third down. Gets out to about the 37-yard line. The Falcons are going to call their second timeout. Tackle made at the 49-yard line. From their own 49-yard line, it's second down. He's out of bounds at the 45-yard line. He gets it up, and it's wide left. No good.
Every time you have a chance to finish a drive with points, you've got to capitalize. That time, they couldn't come through.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here.
Airing it out long. No, incomplete. We've played a half of football. The Cougars in front, 10-3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Things are straight defensive out there right now. David, what do these two offenses have to do to open this game up?
Well, it's fun to watch because obviously I'm a defensive guy and I enjoy this, but when your defense is executed at that kind of level, the offense has to be precise. I mean, you got to throw it in tight windows. You got to be willing to take some chances that you normally wouldn't have. How about some trick plays, maybe? I mean, when you're losing the battle in the trenches, you got to find some way to kind of even it out. Maybe get a little bit more options, some reverses, some double passes, something to loosen up this defense. Because right now, defenses are just winning out.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Reese. David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And they can forget about returning this one.
They'll take over here, ready to start a new series.
Going deep, lays it out there. Can't connect.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. They give to the tailback. Bates gained 7 yards on that play.
That makes it third and three.
He's tackled right around the 42-yard line. We've got a first and 10.
Ball on their own 42. They'll work the right side. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. 3 yard gain by the running back.
Not much gained on that play because this safety did a wonderful job of getting up there and making a good tackle on the ball carrier.
And he's taken down at the 43-yard line.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. Fires it out.
He's at the 40, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that ball.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Tackle around the 38-yard line.
So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. Pressure got to him, and it's picked off.
It's a good play when the corner can break up a pass, but it's even better when he can bring it in for an interception.
To the 40. He's at midfield. And down he goes.
Right around the 48-yard line. First down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 48. Down at the 37.
That's a gain of 11 on the drive. First down.
Not over here.
Fumble. They fall on it. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Play fake and looking to run. That's a great tackle at the 18-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Makes the catch and look out. And they push him out at about the 29-yard line. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Throw to the tight end. He's gobbled up in the backfield. A 1 yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. Here's the halfback. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. He's taken down around the 48-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Defense holds, and the ball will change hands. This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
He's at the 40, and they make the stop at the 36. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, the Cougars in front, 10-3. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. The 10. He scores. What a play. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Early in the fourth quarter, who's going to make a play? Which team's going to come out on top? We're in a tie game, and we're about to find out. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. He fights forward to about the 30.
recovered, and he's level at the 18.
And they're lucky to retain possession of the ball there.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Gibson will be the return man. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Tackle made at the 41-yard line. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. And he's tackled at the 47. It's first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Makes it out to about the 30. He's at the 20, makes it to the 14. And for Weber, he's had a good performance, getting to 100 yards with that last carry.
Brad, you and I talked this week about what we thought he might be able to do against this defense, and clearly he has lived up to our expectation. And I got to believe that his consistency is going to be a big key in determining the outcome of the game.
Man left.
First and 10, ball on the 14. And he gets the touchdown. And he hits the PAT. A four-play, 58-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
Weber gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And he's stopped behind the line.
I think calling the plays, you've got to be aware of this guy. He's making too many plays. He's that close to the line of scrimmage, defending the run, not allowing your running back to even get up to the line of scrimmage. You've got to do something to make him pay for that. If he's going to cheat up to the line of scrimmage, if you're calling the plays, listen up. This is a great time to go play action and try to throw the ball right over top of his head.
He makes it to the 25-yard line. It's third down and long, and losing by a possession, I would expect them to have to go to the air. Just over 2 minutes in the game. And he can't get away from the pressure.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Gibson awaiting the return. Booming kick. Gibson fields it at the 34. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. The Falcons have been rolling on offense, and they look at the scoreboard, and it's still a tight ballgame.
I can't believe that this is still a close game. As you said, they have such a huge advantage, and yet it's a tight game. They've just blown too many opportunities.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. He fights forward to about the 46. Bishop gets about a yard on the play. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 46.
takes it right and brought down right away.
Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
The Cougars use their second timeout.
They'll bring him down at the 48. A two-yard run by the halfback.
Now, there's going to be some time left on the clock after this punt. The defense had better be ready because this game is going to be on them.
Hirsch is back awaiting the punt. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Fires out to his receiver. Stops the clock with a spike.
It's third and five. Ball on their own 25. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Quick throw. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
From their own 47-yard line, it's first down. They come out on an empty backfield. Gets hit out of bounds at the 49. Once and all, going deep. And it's caught. Touchdown. Huge play.
The extra point to tie this game up. Here's the call from the referee.
Delay of game. Offense.
Just over a minute left.
And he tacks on the extra point.
A six-play, 81-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Late in the fourth quarter now, tie football game, and if we're headed to overtime, I hope it's going to be as good as what we've seen through four quarters. He's at midfield. And he was that close to turning that into a big play. So it's first and 10 after the big run. over the middle to his tailback. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26. Slings it. Tackle at the 2-yard line. The Falcons are going to call their second timeout. He's in for the touchdown. And he converts the extra point. If they field this kick, they'll have to bring it all the way back for a touchdown, or this one's over. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
He lets it fly. Incomplete. Romero's day comes to an end, not how he had planned it to go, but hey, team rallied around him beautifully.
Brad, I think you and I and everybody else expected a big day for him individually, and he didn't. But most importantly, the team, as you said, was able to come up and kind of step in for his absence and win this football game.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.